How on earth do you make Premiere Pro use up less disk space? What are all these CFA and PEK files, and can I delete them? Let's find out. Okay, so this is a quick tutorial on how to undertake a couple of steps that will help you to reduce the amount of space taken up by some of your Premiere Pro projects. Premiere Pro is a bit of a resource beast. Anyone regularly making content will know how quickly you can chew up a few hundred gig of disk space, and if you, like me, are quite meticulous about saving backups, both offline and online, then you'll more than likely benefit from this simple tutorial. First of all, let's get a recent project which I finished with. I just want to archive it. This particular folder is currently 5.8 gig, which isn't too bad compared to some projects. There are just over 300 files and a nice nest of 37 folders. Now fire up Premiere Pro and open up the project you wish to archive. Then in Premiere Pro, click File, then Project Manager. As described by Adobe on their website, the Premiere Pro Project Manager helps to facilitate an efficient archiving or transcoding workflow by performing two functions: collecting or copying the current project and all of its associated media files to a single location for sharing, and consolidating files associated with a project for transcoding into a single codec for easy archiving. In my case, I'm using the Project Manager quite specifically for deleting all of the additional unneeded files that Premiere Pro creates, and to ignore all of the extra stuff I might have thought I'd need for a project but have subsequently not used. Now in the Project Manager screen, you'll see a number of options, but the main space-saving options you'll need to be aware of are on the right-hand side. We've got Exclude Unused Clips, we need to tick this, and Include Audio Conform Files, we'd want to untick this. These are the CFA and PEK files, or Adobe PEK Waveform and Conformed Audio files. These are stored audio files that contain audio data that has been conformed to a proprietary Adobe format. They're pre-rendered snippets of audio that are saved in your project folders, basically using them as a cache for speedy access while you're tracking through your timeline. These files can take up quite a lot of space and can be safely deleted. We've got the Include Preview Files option. You need to untick this. When selected, this specifies that effects that you rendered in the original project remain rendered in the new project. When not selected, the new project occupies less disk space, but the effects are not rendered. Again, this is simply a cache that's used while you're working on your project. Make sure you select a destination. In my case, I'm selecting my NAS for archiving. Incidentally, as well as this NAS being in another location on-site, it's also backed up nightly to an off-site location. There are a number of services available for this, such as Backblaze or Google Drive, Office 365, etc. You'll notice that my project is showing it'll shrink by around 300 meg. Now that's obviously not something to be sniffed at, but the thing it's not showing here is all of the files that are in the project folders but aren't actually included in the project at all. In my case, these will have been pasted in at some point as I was dumping files in either from the camera or an SD card or a mobile phone. Don't forget the actual folder size of this project was 5.8 gig. Clearly there's a point to note here. Be aware that this process will only keep files that are actually used in the sequence. Make sure that you have other copies of these files if you wish to keep them. This is particularly important if you've made recordings in Premiere Pro, such as voiceovers, but haven't actually used them in the end project. These will be deleted. Once you're happy with the options you've selected, hit OK. Now, depending on the size of the project, the speed of your drives, and the options you've selected, it may take a few seconds or it may take a few minutes. Once it's done, it's a good idea to close down Premiere Pro, go to the location of your archive project, and open it up from there and just check to make sure that you're happy with it. Also, just check out the space savings we've achieved here. We've gone from 5.8 gig and over 300 files, down to a measly 3.6 gig and 43 files. And that pretty much wraps it up. We've managed to tidy up our working folder, clean up all of the cache files that we no longer need, and we've got the smallest possible set of files required to edit your project, if ever we needed to revisit it. This sort of process should already be part of your workflow, but it's often neglected. Don't leave it until it's too late. Make sure everything you consider to be precious is archived and backed up. If you have any comments, please leave them below and I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching.